Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain a numerical on Internet Protocol version 4 which will illustrate the use of TTL and protocol fields of the IPv4 header. The example is an IP packet has arrived with the first few hex digits as 45000280001 5 times 0 1 02 and so on. How many hops can this packet travel before being dropped? The data belongs to which upper layer protocol? Now here we are given the hexadecimal dump of an IP packet and we are supposed to determine the number of hops which the packet can take and the data to which the upper layer and the data belongs to which upper layer protocol. Now for such examples, first of all, write the given hexadecimal dump in such a manner that you are able to identify the fields of IPv4 header. Now, the first hexadecimal digit corresponds to the version field of IPv4. It is specifying that version 4 is in use. The second hexadecimal digit corresponds to 4-bit field of HLEN, and HLEN field always specifies the header size in multiples of 4 bytes. Therefore, here the header size is 5 multiplied by 4 bytes, that is 20 bytes, fixed size of IPv4 header. The next two hexadecimal digits corresponds to the service type. Service type specifies the type of service depending on the reliability, throughput and cost requirements, and it assigns the priority to the services. Then the next four hexadecimal digits correspond to total length field. Here the total length field is 0028 in hexadecimal, means 40 bytes in decimal. And the identification field corresponds to 0001. The flags and fragment offset field corresponds to 0000. The time to leave field corresponds to the hexadecimal value 01. It is 8-bit field. And the protocol field corresponds to the hexadecimal value 02. Now here for this particular example, we are interested in TTL field value and protocol field value because we have to answer the questions based on these two values. The TTL field value is having 01 digits in hexadecimal and the protocol field corresponds to 02 in hexadecimal. Now if the value in the protocol field is 1, then it means that the data is coming from ICMP protocol at the network layer. If the protocol field value is 2, means the data belongs to IGMP protocol, Internet Group Management Protocol. If the protocol field value is 6, it means the data is coming from TCP to the network layer. If the protocol field value is 17, it means that the data belongs to the UDP protocol and it is UDP protocol and it comes at the network layer from UDP. Then if the protocol field value is 89, it means that the data coming at the network layer is from the OSPF protocol. Now here particularly the protocol field is having value 02, it means that the data is coming from the IGMP protocol at the network layer. So one question is answered here. Now the TTL field is having value 01. 01 means the packet can travel to maximum one hop before reaching to the desired destination. Now let us try to understand the use of TTL field over here. If a packet is transmitted by a source and it is meant for a destination which is 3 hops away. Let us say there are 3 routers in between the source and the destination. And the packet generated at the source side will have the TTL field value set to say 4. When the packet is received at the first router, the TTL field value will be decremented by 1. When the packet is received at the second router, the TTL field value will be decremented by 1 again, so it will become 2. At the third router, the TTL field value will be decremented by 1, it will become 1. And at the destination, the TTL field value will become 0. So, when a packet is transmitted at the source, the TTL field value is set, and when it reaches at the appropriate destination, the TTL field value becomes 0. Now, here in this case, the TTL field value is set to 1, means the packet can reach at the max one router, because at this router, the TTL field value will be decremented by 1. It will be 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So here in this case, the packet can travel to one router at the max because the TTL field will become 0 at this router. And this packet received at this router will not be forwarded further. So here this answers the second question also, and the example is complete. Thank you.